Hi kids, Jones here.
And it's worth an additional 20 adventure bucks.
Adventure Fun Flashback Sunday! Made it.
Well, hi, Santa Ana.
Well, hi, Rebecca.
You're a little late today.
Well, you know, being an adventurer of the Bible does have its twists and turns. You know, especially when you're all over the globe trying to find Bible treasures to bring to kids.
Really?
Yeah, you know that plane I took to Africa?
Yeah.
It's a one-way ticket.
Wow. Did you have to swim back?
No. I bailed out of a taxi to get here on time.
Ouch. You okay?
I'm fine.
Great.
Yeah, no problem. Junior Explorers, we're glad you joined us. Thank you. We're going to be bringing Adventure Bible Church to you every Sunday until we can meet again.
That's right.
And we're going to have a great service today, too.
That's right. Before we get started, make sure you grab a pencil and a piece of paper because you'll need that later on.
That's right. We're going to have memory verse, we're going to have craft, we're going to have a Bible answer game. It's going to be fun.
We're going to have worship time.
That's right, worship time too.
Oh, and you know what? I heard Gerbert's going to be here today.
Gerbert?
Well,
yeah. Every time I'm here, he's not. And every time I'm gone, he shows up.
Well, maybe you guys will run into each other today.
Maybe. We'll see. But before we get started, we're going to open with prayer. So please join us. Lord, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your mercy. And I pray, Father, that this service will be a blessing to everyone. I pray you'll open their hearts to hear your word. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, worship team, take it away. But kids, before we start with the worship, make sure you put some dancing shoes on because you're going to need it.
What you doing?
I'm dancing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. Fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. The fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. You wanna be a banana? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. The fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. You wanna be a watermelon? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a lemon. The fruit of the Spirit's not a lemon. You wanna be a lemon? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Oh, the fruit of the Spirit's not a cherry. The fruit of the Spirit is not a cherry. If you want to be a cherry, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Okay! Everybody knows that grapes come in bunches, so everybody get in big bunches. The fruit of the Spirit is not a grape. The fruit of the Spirit is not a grape. You wanna be a grape? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. The fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and self-control.
Without you.
decide will I need to stay. I'll be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'll be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you.
Kids, that was awesome worship. Man, those are really cool songs, and the worship team was awesome too. Anyway, we hope you really enjoyed that. Hey, I heard there's rumors that Gerbert might be here today. What do you think? Keep a lookout for him. Hey, it's Gerbert, check it out.
Is one of my favorites. It's about how much Jesus loves children. One day, when Jesus was teaching a big crowd of people, some of the mommies and daddies were bringing their children up to Jesus just to be touched by him. Their parents knew that if they had Jesus in their lives, the children would be very special. The children liked to be near Jesus, too. He was kind and gentle, and they could tell that he really loved them. Jesus' helpers tried to keep the people away. They thought that Jesus was too busy to spend time with children. Jesus showed them that children are just as important as grown-ups, and sometimes more important. He told his friends to let the children come see him. Jesus said that grown-ups have to be like children to get into the kingdom of heaven. He even said that doing something nice for a child would be like doing something nice just for him. Jesus also said that every child has angels watching over them, and that God doesn't want anything bad to happen to any little boys or girls. God and Jesus love children so much that they want every single one to come and live in heaven with them forever and ever. And that's a long time. I may be short, short, short. I may be tall, tall, tall. But God has time for me. I may be big, big, big. I may be small, small, small. But God has time for me. I may be short, short, short. I may be tall, tall, tall. But God has time for me. I may be big, big, big. I may be small, small, small. But God has time for me. I may be short, short, short. I may be tall, tall, tall. but God is dying for me. I may be big, 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 I may be small, 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 but God is dying for me. Sing along! I may be short, 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 I may be tall, 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 but God is dying for me. I may be big, 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 I may be small, 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 but God is dying for me. I may be short, 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 I may be tall, 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 but God is dying for me. You know he does. I may be big, 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 I may be small, 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 but God is dying for me. Yeah!
Thanks, Gerbert. What a great story. And it's a great reminder that Jesus loves the little children, which brings us to this week's adventure memory verse. We find it in Matthew chapter 19, verse 14, and it reads like this. Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." Again, Matthew 19, 14. Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." All right, now what we want you to do this week is grab a pen and paper, write down the memory verse, and memorize it. After you memorize it, I want your parents, one of them, to sign off under your memory verse, take a picture of it, and send it to the email address listed below, and we will keep track and award you with Adventure Bucks for doing such.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the 5-0 Answer Game. Coming from sunny Southern California, it's your host, the 5-0 Answer Guy. Let's hear it for the 5-0 Answer Guy.
Okay, enough of that. Anyway, so I'm the 5-0 Answer Guy, and here's what we're going to do. We're going to have 10 questions. You'll have 10 seconds to answer them and write them down. So make sure you have a piece of paper and a pencil. Okay. So here we go. You ready? And here we go. What river did John the Baptist baptize Jesus in? That's right. What river did John the Baptist baptize Jesus in? Okay, here we go. The River Jordan. Here we go. Okay, next one. Which disciple betrayed Jesus in Gethsemane? Which disciple betrayed Jesus in Gethsemane? Take your time, you only got a few seconds. This is fun, I like this. Okay, stand by, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and Judas Iscariot. Hope you got that one right. Okay, after Jesus died, how many days was it until he rose again? How many days after Jesus died did he raise from the dead? Come on, this is, you can get this one. Okay. The answer is 3 days. Here we go. Mary and Joseph couldn't find Jesus one day. He had stayed behind at the temple. What did Jesus tell them when they found him? Mary and Joseph couldn't find Jesus one day. He stayed behind the temple. What did Jesus tell them when they found him? He said, "Didn't you know? I have to be in my Father's house." I know, that's a little tough one. It's not as easy as everybody thinks. Here we go. So here was the next one. Here we go. Jesus rode on a donkey into what city? Jesus rode on a donkey into what city? Uh-huh. Oh, think about it. Think about it. It's Jerusalem. All right. Hope you got that one right, too. I know some of these are kind of, they're a little tough. Okay. Mary and Joseph had to travel to this city to take a census. What city was that? There's some songs about it and stuff like that. It's around Christmas time. Okay, you ready? Bethlehem. Bethlehem. All right. How many disciples were part of Jesus' closest followers? How many disciples were part of Jesus' closest followers? Yeah. You guys heard this before. I have done it before at the Adventure Church. Okay. 12 disciples. What is the name that Jesus was sometimes called? That means master or teacher. Okay, I'm going to repeat that. What is the name that Jesus was sometimes called? That means master or teacher. I know, it's a little tricky. That's a tough one. Rabbi. Okay, here we go. Almost finished here. Who were the first visitors to see the newborn baby Jesus? Who were the first visitors to see the newborn baby Jesus? Mm-hmm. Waiting. Did you write it down? Okay. Shepherds. Okay. To whom did Jesus say, this is the last one, this is a good one. To whom did Jesus say the kingdom of heaven belongs? To whom did Jesus say the kingdom of heaven belongs? You got to get this one, because you're one of them right now. The children. Well, you've written down your answers, take a picture and send them to the email below. All right, and we'll take we'll give you extra credit there for your Bible adventure bucks, okay? All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, that's it for this week's Bible Answer Game. Let's hear it for the Bible Answer Guy.
All right, everybody, it's time for craft. And today's craft comes from our Bible verse for the week, Matthew 19:14, where Jesus talks about loving the little children. And he loves the little children all over the world, which brings us to a craft like this. Jesus loving the children all over the world. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a couple pages available on the Kids Adventure Church website. There'll be two pages. You'll have one page like this. We're going to color everything and then cut out the circles and then cut out the heart, Jesus and his robe. And then you're going to color the picture of the world. You don't have to cut out this page, because what you're going to do is you're going to paste all of your pictures that you cut out all over like this. And you can arrange it however you want. But at the end, what we want you to do when you're finished is we want you to take a picture of it, send it to the email address listed below, and we will award you some adventure bucks for the week. Have fun and good luck.
All right, Junior Explorers, that's going to be all for this week's Adventure Bible Church Online. We hope you had a great time, because we sure did.
That's right, Santa Ana. We did.
And we're going to keep bringing this to you every week until we can meet again in person, because we really miss you guys.
We do. And make sure you email us all of your assignments for today so that we can award you all of your adventure bucks.
And while I'm out exploring for new Bible adventures, you guys have a great week, a blessed week, and we'll see you next week. I got to catch a plane.
Hey, make sure it's a round trip this time.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining this week's Adventure Bible Church Online. And visit our website at lifekidsabc.org.